Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. So this is your fourth experiment that we are going to perform today. Okay. So today we are going to do the RLC series circuit. Okay. So let me share the screen first.
Koyal Kamsha, main credit dena kabhi nahi bhulti apne bhai behno ko, because they are the best. I love them. Doing you've created such a
beautiful. Hello everyone, mute yourself. Okay, so this is your RLC series circuit. Is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is your RLC series circuit. So what we are going to do today, this is the total RLC series circuit, the resistance, the inductor, and one capacitor is connected in series here. Okay, and we are going to measure the voltage across each element, and here in input we are giving 230 volt 50 hertz AC. Okay, just a minute, let me admit him. Okay, so we are giving here 230 volt 50 hertz single phase AC supply. And here the capacitor value is fixed, resistor value fixed, and we are only changing this inductor. Okay, inductor value, we are varying the value of this inductor. Now here look, this coil is here, that means here we are using the variac. Okay, and variable voltage we can supply in our system, and see, in parallel one voltmeter is already connected. Okay, and here the input voltage we can see from that meter. Correct. So this is your basic RLC series circuit diagram. And when the inductor is connected in the circuit, what is your total impedance? That is calculated by V by I equals to root under of R square plus X square. Okay. This AC circuit that we will learn from the next class. Okay, in theoretical class, because this series RLC circuit we still didn't learn. Okay, so I will show you how to calculate the impedance. So for that time being, look here, this is the total impedance, that is called Z. Okay, Z equals to root under of R square plus XL square. Okay, just a minute. Okay. Hello, am I audible?
Yes,
Hello? Okay. So all of you write
sir.
this table first,
Yes.
experimental data. Okay. After the experiment, we are going to take these data. Okay. So all of you write this table in your copy right now. Okay. All of you write this first table that is experimental data that you are getting from the experiment. Okay. After that, what you need to write, what you need to calculate, I will say. Okay. So all of you first write down this experimental table, first table. Hello, have you written the experimental table, first experimental table?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so first of all, in this circuit, as you can see, in this circuit, we are giving the supply, okay, that is 230 volt, 50 hertz AC supply. Then through this ammeter, we are going to measure the current. Then, using the multimeter or voltmeter, this VR will be calculated and this VL will be calculated. Okay. The concept of inductor I already told you. Okay. Now, this what is the unit of inductor? Can you tell me? What is the unit?
Henry.
Henry, exactly. But what is the unit of resistance?
Ohm.
Ohm, right. So how can you plus or how can you match those elements with inductor with the resistor? So we have to convert this Henry, that unit of the inductor, into the ohm. Okay, so for that conversion, what we are doing, we will do the omega into L. What is omega? That is 2 pi F. Just remember this thing now. Okay, when I show you, when I take your theoretical class, I will describe that in detail. Okay, so here, in case of this resistance, the unit is ohm. Okay. And the unit of this inductance is Henry. So we have to convert that Henry into ohm. How? We have to multiply omega with L. Now, what is omega? That is 2 into pi into F. What is F? That is the frequency of the system. Here, what is your frequency? See, 50 hertz. Okay. So whatever inductor value you have, multiply it with 100 pi, that means 2 into pi into 50, that is 100 pi. Similarly, capacitor unit is farad. Okay, so we have to convert that farad unit into the ohm. So how can we convert that? We have to do 1 by omega c. Okay, that means 1 divided by 100 pi into c value. So whatever value you get, that is your in ohm unit. Okay, now you can calculate the total impedance. Okay, when we consider the inductor, resistor and the capacitor, then in case of the AC circuit, we call it impedance. Okay, now how can we calculate that impedance? That impedance value we can calculate like this: R square plus X square whole root. Okay, now what is this X? X is called the inductance. Okay, XL is called inductance, and this XC, that is also in ohm unit. Okay, this is the process how you can calculate the total impedance of the circuit. Okay, so now we are switching to the practical part. Okay, now I am stopping the screen sharing.
Hello. Am I audible to everyone? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is your experimental setup here. This is your capacitor box that will offer you XC. This is your inductor coil. And this is the resistive load that will offer the resistance in the circuit. In these meters, this meter will show the voltage across the capacitor. This meter will show the voltage across the inductor. Here, this voltmeter will show the supply voltage or input voltage to the entire circuit. And this ammeter will show you the current through the resistive load. Now, this by using this variac, we will change the input voltage to the circuit and study the entire circuit. Manish sir.
Here you see one instrument. This is called variac. Okay. It is an auto transformer. It is induction type. It has two terminals. One is common, another is phase. Okay. We give it 220 volt AC, 50 hertz single phase supply. But we get output voltage from 0 to 270 volt. Okay. We can vary the voltage by this knob. Okay. Here you see one voltmeter. This voltmeter is always connected in parallel. This voltmeter is moving iron type instrument. Here you see one symbol that is resistance then cross. Okay. Resistance then cross. This symbol indicates it is its type. It is moving iron type instrument. Moving iron type instruments uses both AC and DC. It has three terminal. One is common is must. I will take out of two, either we take 150 or 300. Okay. Yeah, if we need maximum voltage 150, then we can add 150. If you need maximum voltage 300, then we take 300. But in this case, we take 300. So here you see that here two voltmeter is connected always in parallel. That means two different two terminal is connected to different two terminals of the variac voltmeter. Okay, this one is connected to 300. This terminal is connected to 300, and this is connected to common. So this one is common and this one is phase. Okay, now this voltmeter is now parallel to the variac. Next we will connect on ammeter. Ammeter is always connected in series. That means common is connected to the common of the ammeter. So this common is connected to the common. This one is input, and this one is output. One terminal. Okay, that is maximum current measured by this ammeter, 1 ampere. Okay, and ammeter output is connected to the resistor input. Okay, this one is resistor input. Okay, so in this panel board, you see three voltmeter. This one is VR, VL, and VC. Okay, so three voltmeter will be connected in parallel to the resistor, inductor, and capacitor. Okay, so these two are with C1 tungsten lamp. So these two are terminal of the tungsten lamp. Okay, so this voltmeter will be connected in parallel to the resistor. That means this parallel connection means two different two terminals will be connected to the different two terminals of the voltmeter. Okay, so here we see this terminal is connected to here, and this terminal is connected to here. This by this wire. Okay. Now this voltmeter is parallel to the resistor. So this voltmeter gives us VR. Okay. Next this one inductor. Okay. This inductor two terminal is connected to the different two terminals of the voltmeter. This one is connected to here, and this one is connected to here. Now this voltmeter is parallel to the inductor. So this voltmeter gives us VR. Next these two are capacitor terminal. Okay. So this capacitor terminal is connected to different two terminals of the voltmeter. So this one is connected to this one voltmeter one terminal, and this one is connected to the another voltmeter terminal. This one is by this one. Okay. This voltmeter is parallel to the capacitor. So this voltmeter gives us DC. Okay. But our experiment is RLC circuit. RLC circuit means output of the inductor. Output of the inductor is connected to the resistor inductor input by this one. Okay. Next, inductor output will be connected to the capacitor input by this wire. This one is connected to here. Capacitor inductor output. Inductor output is connected to the capacitor input. So now RLC are in series. Okay. And capacitor output is connected to the phase of the circuit. So this one is connected to the phase. Any question regarding the circuit connection? Any question regarding the circuit connection? No query. Fine. So we are proceeding to now. We'll take reading. Okay. Observation table. All of you note down all the values that we are getting from our experiment. Okay.
So now we increase the voltage slowly. What is one certain voltage when when VL and VC will be equal? Okay. This voltage will be. Here we can find the voltage. So we will take upper reading. Okay. So now in this case, voltage is 118 volt. Okay. In this situation, we see VL and VC and VL is equal. Okay. So this is the condition of this for a stress plot. Okay. So everybody note down this reading.
So what is your first supply voltage? Supply voltage is 118 volt. And what is your current? Check here. Current value is 0.28. Okay. And what is the voltage across the resistor? Look, the bulb is glowing and this is working as a resistor. Okay. Now this value is almost 105.
VRL.
Okay.
VRL.
This is your VRL and VC.
That's 100. Are the V capital RL? You see in multiplication. Now you measure VRL. Okay. So by this multimeter, we can measure VRL. Okay.
Look how much value you are getting, that is 150. Okay, it is fluctuating from 149 to 50. So we are taking here 150. Everyone note down all the data.
Okay, next reading will be we decrease the inductor value. Okay. And we'll also take the reading, okay? For the capacitor is maximum, we take value is 10 microfarad, okay? And inductor value is 2 Henry, okay.
Now we are changing the value of the inductor. Okay. We are basically decreasing the inductor value, keeping the resistor value, resistance value, and the capacitance value as it is. Now we are going to check how much difference we are getting based on the readings. Okay. At the same supply voltage. Okay, now we are increasing the voltage to the same value, that is 118 volt.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, you mute yourself.
Yes, yes, already we are muted. Don't worry.
Okay, sir.
Hello. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, you have already seen the condition where VL and VR and VC, all three are equal. Now, in this case, in the next case, we are going to study. We have fixed the value of the capacitor at 10 microfarad. Here you can see it. We have fixed it at 10 microfarad. We will fix the supply voltage at 118 volt while we'll vary, while we'll start the experiment. We have already a fixed resistance here. And now this time, at the previous case, we have connected the inductor value at 2 Henry. Now in this case, we have connected, we have increased the inductor value at 5 Henry here. You can see the leads have been placed at 5 Henry terminal. So now our inductor value have been increased to 5 Henry from 2 Henry. Now in this case, we will see what happens or how the VC, VL and VR reacts. In this case, with the same supply voltage. See, we're increasing the supply voltage. So see here, we have given the same supply voltage, 118 volt. Here you can see, this is the value of XC or the, I should say VC. Total 80 volt. Yeah, you can see the reading. It is 80 volt. The value of VC is 80 volt. Next, we have to take the value of VL by using the multimeter. See here, it is 5 volt. The value of VL is 5 volt. So, write down the value of VL now is 5 volt
VL.
And the value of VR
first
division 60 plus 6 60 are adequate to 60 plus 15 that is 75 volt. So VR is 75 volt.
That is
0.24 ampere. Supply current is 0.24 ampere. Now we will take the value of
VRL. V capital R L. Okay.
You can see here 76.9 volt. So this is the experimental data that we have gathered from our second set of data, that is supply voltage 118 volt, then current through the circuit is 0.24 ampere here. The value against the voltage across the resistance VR is 75 volt. VRL, value of VRL that we have taken on multimeter, that is 5 volt. The value of VC, voltage across the capacitor, is 80 volt. And the value of VRL, capital RL, is 76.9 volt. It is also being taken from multimeter, 76.9 volt. Now we will decrease the value of the inductor and see what happens. See here, we have decreased the value of the inductor at 1 Henry this time. Already we have remained the value of the capacitor at 10 microfarad. And the resistor is also constant. Let's see. We will again. Now again, see, the supply voltage is 118 volt, input voltage. Point one. Input current is 0.1 ampere. The voltage across the inductor is 142 volt. Consider it as 142 volt. Since the position of the pointer is a little bit higher than the position 140. So the voltage across the inductor is 142 volt. Now we'll see the voltage across the capacitor. See, this is 31.7 volt. We'll now see the voltage VR It is 6.8 volt. Voltage across the resistor, 6.8 volt. And lastly, we'll calculate the voltage across VRL. And that is 143.7 volt. Now we have gathered all our three readings. See the last one, 118 input volt, 118. Input current is 0.1 ampere. Voltage across the resistance 6.8 volt. Voltage VRL, voltage across the inductor 142 volt. VC, voltage across the capacitor 31.7 volt. And VRL capital is 143.7 volt. Have you jotted down all the readings? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we'll proceed to the calculation part.
Now students see that we get one, we take observation table, this one, okay. So next this one is the calculation table, okay. So by this observation table we can calculate this observation table, okay. So now first is R, okay. R is equal to VR by I, okay. So we get VR. So reading number one, we get VR is 105. So 105 divided by 0.28 by VR and I, we can calculate R. Okay. Am I audible to you? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Next is XC. So formula of XC is equal to VC by I. Okay. So we take reading of VC. So VC by I, that means from first reading, VC is 100 and I is 0.28. So 100 divided by 0.28, by this formula, we can get find out the XC. Next C. C is equal to 1 by omega C, okay? So value of the omega is 2 pi F. So F is 50 hertz and 2 into pi into F, that means 2 into 22 by 7 into 50. And VC, we earlier taking the reading of VC. By this formula, we will find out value of C. Okay. Next reading is XL. Okay. So here we see some formula. Okay, these two formula, by these two formula, okay, the equation number one and equation number two, we have to find out the value of small r. Okay, by this two formula we find out the small r by putting small r and I and v r comma l, we will find out the value of xl. Okay, everybody understand and what I am speaking you? Hello
sir, please say again.
By this formula we will find out the value of small r. Okay, by putting this small r I and v I r comma l, we will find out xl. Hello. Hello. So you may calculate the XL by the formula VL by I. Okay. Hello. Am I audible to you?
XL
yes,
is
VL by I. Okay. So by getting XL, we will find out the value of R. By this, I previously tell you the two formula. By the two formula, we find out the small r. Okay. Next, we will find out L. L is XL by omega. Omega, value of the omega is 2 pi f. Next, Z. Z is V by I. Next, power. Power is equal to I square capital R plus small r. Okay. And next, cos theta is R capital R plus small r divided by Z. Okay. So students, you will calculate this table at home, okay? And also you will note down this this table, okay? I give you time to 2 minutes. Note down in this observation table. Hello, everybody done this note down this observation table? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you just give your attendance. Rule number one.
Yes, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six. Rule number six. Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Present, sir.
Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12. 13.
Present, sir.
14. 15.
Present, sir.
Sir, roll number 12, present.
Sir, roll number 6, present.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Present, sir.
18. 18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present.
23.
Present, sir.
24. 25.
Present, sir.
26. 27.
Present, sir.
28.
Present, sir.
29.
Present, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32. 32. 24. Present. Roll number 14. Okay, student. Thank you, everybody. So, who are giving attendance? We may leave the meeting. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
I also request you to follow Google Classroom. Okay.
Sir, roll number 6 present. Can I check, please, again?
6 DD.
Present. Hello.
Hello.
Roll number 8.
Roll number 8. Present, sir. 21 as a roll number 21 as a roll number 21.
Hi.